Alright guys, it's Team 3's time back with another One Piece Benner's video. In today's video, we're looking at Lawffy, actually. Kind of a oddball pick for me. Shoutouts to Roige for giving me this gameplay. My Lawffy actually isn't max yet. I think he's 85, actually. And I was actually using him in 2v2s, and he isn't too bad. And I know this man Roige actually was like a really, really big Lawffy simp when he first came out. So I was like, you know, he's probably one of the better Lawffys that I've seen. So I was like, you know, just shoot me some gameplay if you want. And, you know, here we are. Taking a look at the metal set, though, that he's rocking. He's actually rocking a pretty interesting set. It's not like the go-to attacker set or whatever you want to call it, the Lucy double Dressrosa Luffy set. It's actually really interesting, like I said. So he's rocking Bounce Man, which is damage increase, I think, in enemy treasure. Lawffy as well for more damage increase. And then he's actually rocking a Sobacart metal, which gives you heal on crit. And this Lawffy actually does get, I think, 300% crit chance or whatever when somebody dies on your team. So I think his whole point is just to try to get a little bit of heals going on, because this Lawffy, or this Luffy, should I say, whatever, is a little bit squishy. He's always been squishy, I feel like. So getting those heals is actually really interesting. And I'm actually surprised he's not rocking defense on him instead. But, you know, for his percentages, though, he has 3.6k HP and 1.1 attack. Really good percentages, actually. And I know this man is actually free to play. So, I mean, comparing it to, like, my metal sets, I think this is actually really, really optimal. For the tags, you get some cat speed, some cooldown reduction of dodge, and then for his percentages, HP is 54, attack is 28, and then if this video wants to go, you also get damage reduction, increased damage though when you have less treasures. When your allies are next to you in the treasure area, you get 7% more increased damage, and then you also get the 5% from the two metals, and then 3% HP per crit. And then there's also, for his percentages, is 32% attack from Straw Hat Pirates and Paramecia. You get another 18% attack. So actually really good percentages there. Looking at his support, though, he is rocking 146 actually. 146.3. He's rocking a mixed support with Film Red Shanks. Lots of mixed supports going on here. I think you guys already know that I'm not the biggest fan of mixed support, but it does do well. For his tags, he's rocking Straw Hat Pirates, New World, Grand Line Attacker, fucking video, man. Paramecia, Captain, Runner, Defender, and Grand Line. Full tags are 4 full tags. Like I said, percentage is 146.3, which is actually still really good. I'm actually surprised he actually has Adio and Rebecca on support. Maybe he's a little bit lacking on that, but, you know, either way, it's not a bad support for a free-to-play. Like I said, this Luffy, he can do really good. He's not the greatest unit nowadays. I feel like he didn't age too well, especially because of his normals are kind of whack. They're good for movement, but you know, it's not exactly my go-to, you know, if I were to use this guy. Mainly, he's just for support, but that's just me. Like I said, this Luffy's still really good, though. The Shambles skill still hits pretty hard. The only thing that does suck is that a lot of people nullify that little stagger that he does. So, like, if you're trying to, you know, catch a fucking, like a Film Red Shanks, for example, he'll either just heal off the skill or he could just dodge it. Same thing with Roger sometimes. So a lot of those characters that do have, like, nullify stagger when they're getting hit or whatever, that can kind of fuck you up. He also does have an anti-heal. He shoots out the Law, which is actually, I still think it's better than Onigashima Law, even when he came out, just because Luffy isn't the one that's actually shooting himself out. It's just the Law. So you won't get punished for, you know, fucking up the skill. It'll just be the Law that comes out. He does his radio knife and he just leaves. So obviously this whole character is it's honestly just the Law. The Law carries. but with that being said, the Shambles though, it's pretty fucking hard. If you can't hit it down, hit it off. It has burn. You can pick off a lot of people from different areas around the map. It has a pretty decent range for what it is. It just takes a little bit for it to load because Luffy has a cock his arm back, and then he, you know, puts out the room. So it can be easy to dodge. You just really have to be smart with it. And I actually haven't seen these gameplays yet, so maybe Roige did really good. We'll have to see right now. But yeah, you guys can let me know what you guys think about Lawffy in the comments down below. And yeah, I don't know. We'll have to see how good he does. Obviously, I'm not going to do any post commentary, but I'll probably talk about it like in the description if you do want to, you know, see what I thought about the gameplay. But yeah, with that being said, this is Lawffy. Hope you guys enjoy the video, and this team 3 star signing out, and I'll see you guys next video. Peace. All right, so I decided to do a commentary actually today, just because it's a little bit different from what I usually do. I know a lot of people kind of want me to do more commentary. I've done a couple in the past, but you know, we're gonna be talking over Roige's gameplay. I guess I might as well, you know, it'll get my thoughts out while I watch, because like I said, I actually haven't watched the gameplay yet, so it'll actually help him. So like I said, Roige is rocking split support, obviously using Lawffy, as the video says. He also has Shanks on the side, but on his team we have a Shanks, an Odin, and a Vista. Pretty interesting right there. And then in his team you got a Big Mom, EX Luffy, King, and Rayleigh. Another interesting fucking pick. I have not seen a Rayleigh in a while. He isn't the best anymore. He can still do good, but I don't know. We'll have to see. Here's the match starting, and right now he's just going to be moving with the normals, because normals do make him go quicker. He's going to get the first flag because he is technically the weakest character, so it'll be, you know, smarter for him to grab it instead of, like, the Shanks or the Odin or whatever. Vids is going off, and he gets hit with King, but then Roige pulls up the King and just smacks him in the tummy. Really fucking good damage there, and then hits him with the anti-heal, and King is down already. Like I said, this Lawffy does phenomenally well against people that you either can't get off the flag easily because you could just pick him up like a radish. And right here, he's just going to get abused by the EX Luffy. 1 HP trait coming in clutch, though, so that's actually pretty good. Right now, he's just kind of throwing hands, trying to perfect dodge. Oh, and he still got the Luffy. Only had 700 health, and he actually still got him. Surprising. He tried to pull the Rayleigh, but he just died, sadly. So we're going to wait for Lawffy to come back. That actually would have been pretty fucking clean if he was stay alive with only 700, but, I mean, it is what it is. Lawffy isn't the tankiest of characters. Even on release, he was very, very squishy anyway, so that's also something to note as well. There's also a who's who on the other team, which is pretty fucking interesting. I have not seen a who's who in League, like, at all. So I end up pulling back. The Rayleigh's right there. I think he's going to try to pick him up right now. The EX Luffy's trying to bait his dodge. Got him with the Snake Man skill. Vista's going to get the help him get the flag right now. The big plate's right there, so I think Roige is going to go get it. Yep, looks about right. The EX Luffy's on the Rayleigh, but Roige over here, 36k crit, damn, takes his kill. Anti-heal, the blue Shanks is really good, so he can actually die, because his man's on crack when he's using his normals. And then look at the shitty normals from Lawffy, but he's still cooking, and now he's fighting the Straw Hat, you know, counter. Let's see how well he does. Crit is up because his teammate died, so he is healing a little bit from the metal set, and anti-heal, I don't even know how much that shit did. It looked like a lot, though. on the who's who, and he is down as well. Team boost is fucking crazy. I'm letting you know right now. Still one of the strongest things in the game. Picks up the EX Luffy because he dodged. Big punish for the girls for that one. EX Luffy's on half health already. Nice perfect dodge. Comboing the normals, and the EX Luffy is down. Sadly, he got his kill taken. Anti-heal the King again. This man Roige probably has something against Kings or something, because he's been on their asses. This Zoro's about to mess him up, though, because Zoro's M1s are so strong. But never mind. Roige kills that fucker, too. Doing phenomenally well for this guy. You know, doing a little bit of a pussy play, kind of, because he had to pull back, but the blue Shanks got him. I know, like, back when Lawffy just first came out, a lot of the times it was just, like, you just, you know, hanging around, waiting for your skills. Kind of like Roger a little bit, but his was a lot worse, because his normals weren't that good. Popping back with Shanks right now, though. He's doing the running skill, hitting, I don't even know who the fuck that hit. I think it was their Shanks. Teleports to Big Mom. Big Mom's invincible, though, so it didn't matter. Just kind of guarding the flag. Doing phenomenally well, and 6.3k score. Really, really good game by Roige. Lawffy doing a lot, actually, from what I expected him to do. You know, beating the who's who, especially, so that's pretty good. We'll have to see the scores, though. And he got MVP with 6 kills and 1 cap. Pretty good shit from there. And we'll go on to the next match. And here's the second match. Once again, on Rogue Town. I think he was just playing on, like, the same maps. I'm pretty sure, because he was just trying to get it recorded as quickly as possible. But, I mean, honestly, Rogue Town is really good for this Lawffy, because he has a lot of range. So you can take advantage of the really big map. Picking up a lot of those runners that are trying to back cap you. Like I said, the King's just getting abused right now, so he can do phenomenally well against King on this map, especially. So right now we're loading in. We got
on his team. So it's him, Zoro, Big Mom, and Odin again. Another fucking Odin. Jeez. Then we got Luffy. Oni Luffy, Uta, King, and Big Mom. Oni Luffy, also an interesting pick. Pretty wild to see these units in League right now, especially Uta's. I actually haven't seen a lot of Uta's lately, so we'll see how good Lawffy does against her if he does fight her. I'm pretty interested in that because I know the shield is really annoying to get through, especially using a character that doesn't have a multi-hit. Getting through that free hit that she gets. The Odin using the skill 2, I think, to get the King off the flag, but he just couldn't do it. He gets tremored and sung to poor Odin, man. Uta's pulling up. Rage using his normals to get rid of the shield. Anti-heal the King again. Damn, this man, I'm telling you, has something against King or something. Pops the skill 2. Punches Uta, 26k crit. One shot. Fucking amazing. Punches her right in the titties. Trying to get this flag right now, though, but Big Mom knocked him back with the laser. The laser hole, or whatever the fuck you call it. Whatever the fuck she calls it. Grab this meat right here because he was half health. Just kind of, like I said, pulling back, pussy play, just waiting until he can use this anti-heal. Tried to use it and just completely fucking whiffs. God damn it, Rage. Fucking suck. I think I was trying to get the King again, but I guess his aiming wasn't the greatest, but it's okay. Watching the Perospero, because Perospero is a fucking nightmare to fight without status notification. And just kind of walking on the edge of the map, gatekeeping. Punches the Big Mom right under coochie with 9k only, though. Eesh. Tries to anti-heal her, but she's invincible. So that was a wasted skill, but it's okay. She's almost dead anyway. If he can aim his normals, that is. the King takes out the Big Mom, though, so it's okay. I'm surprised he hasn't got the B flag yet. I think he's just going to help the King get this flag. Odin's pulling up on their other flag right now. Getting that flag, he's going to pull back and try to weaken up the D flag while, sitting on the D as you do. Right now, the King is piecing up the Big Mom on his team. He might probably pull back and try to kill him right there since he's giving Big Mom a little bit of an issue. But King is actually pulling up to him, waiting for him to attack or whatever, hits him with anti-heal, and the King is down again. Like I said, just completely abusing these Kings for some reason. I think he does have something against those King. Maybe it's because he's black or whatever, but I'm not too sure. You'd have to ask him. Uses the shambles, picks up the only Luffy, actually almost one-shots him. Granted, it is on team boost, but still, that Luffy's still pretty tanky. Anti-heal goes on the Big Mom, good shit from there, so now she can't heal when they get burned and attack her, and she is dead. once again, though, pulling back, kind of feel like a broken record right now. Only Luffy's coming up right now with his normals, making sure you don't get caught, and he got caught with the Hog Gatling. Actually, it doesn't kill him, though, because the dodge... which kind of saved him. So right now I think he's going to try to pull him, but Zoro kind of took his kill, so it's okay. He's doing a good job. He's probably mad right now. Rage is probably punching the air for that. Zoro, once again, fucking up his skill. Wasted the anti-heal. The King hits him, and he actually perfect dodged that, which surprised me. I thought that was a little bit delayed. Trying to punch this stupid dinosaur in his wings, but it's not working, and he gets absolutely destroyed by that. Bikini, Nami, fixed damage still goes crazy. He just got kicked right in the nuts. I bet Lawffy honestly is into like ball stomping. That's probably why Rage got himself killed in the first place. But yeah, we'll see right now the score. If I can see it, 5k. I think that was 3 kills, 2 caps. Pretty good as well. And we'll head on to the next match. So we are in the third match. This is Alabasta Knight. One of the best maps in my opinion. I know a lot of people don't like it. I honestly don't even think that's that bad. Memeing aside, it's really not that bad. Just playing as the right characters, I think. He should be fine. Once again, starting with Lawffy. Again, seems some pretty interesting picks on both teams. We'll see what the other team starts with. But I did see the Mace, which is really interesting. Seeing in 2023, somebody actually using Mace. We'll see. So his team is... Blue Shanks, him, King, and Mace, which is Max, actually. Pretty interesting. Interesting set there, too. We have two Kings, Kaido, Blue Kaido. God damn it. And a Big Mom. We'll see what he does right now. I think he's going to try to get to second flag. Hopefully, he doesn't take first flag from the Mace. Because you know damn well that guy's not going to do anything, sadly. right now, just using normals to move a little bit quicker. I'm pretty sure his 1-2 is actually quicker. I know some people actually do just the 1 combo. But I think it's 1-2. I'm not too sure, though. Grabbing B flag, though. Right now, there's just kind of a little fight going in the middle. The Kings are pulling back right now. Once again, grabbing the King again and punching him right in the dick. What was that? 17k? Pretty good right there. Nice dodge glitch by Rage. Uses the anti-heal, still hits both Big Mom and King even though he was downed. Really, really good part about that skill too, just because it's honestly better than Raid Law, since you don't get hit by that. And because of that, the Big Mom and King are dead from the tornado, which is really good. Even though he doesn't get the kill, technically he does have two. So right now he's going to try to grab C-Flag. Big Mom's pulling up right now. Mace with the horrible shield, but it doesn't matter because he got the flag in time. Kaido's also charging up right now. I think he's going to pick up the Big Mom this time. Yeah, 8k. Not too bad, actually, for all the damage reduction that she does have. She's going runner mode. Perfect dodge. Hit her with the anti-heal. Now, she can't heal, which is really good. Honestly, getting those anti-heals on those units that heal a lot, like this blue Kaido, Big Mom, even Zoro would be really good to have. Right now, just kind of swinging on the Kaido. I'm not sure if that one damage is because the Big Mom fell on him. Hopefully, because that would have been sad. Team Boost is hitting right now. Kaido's trying to pull up, and there's the anti-heal again. But he does get clipped by that skill one. But once again, with the anti-heal, the tornado does kill him anyway. He is on fire. His balls are on fire right now. But he picks up the King again, and 22k crit. No team boost is insane on the King. The King is down. Right now, there's another King that's pulling back. Nice perfect dodge by Rage. Saw the King dodge. Anti-heal, 7k damage is still really good. Perfect dodge to Odin. Saw that from a mile away. Trying to knock him down before he gets hit, but apparently that skill hit. I thought he would be down, so Rage finally goes down. I think he's going to be going into Shanks right now. No, actually, no. Okay, so he's going to be waiting right now. That's just me making sure I don't miss the timer. So kind of ignore that, I guess. And they're just losing every single flag right now. Oh, my God. I think the guy actually waited for Mace, too, so I don't know about that. Maybe he's also doing a showcase or something. And I'm surprised the shock didn't go through the wall. Tries to pick up the Big Mom, but doesn't work. Anti-heals her, though, at least. But he is getting shot by the laser once again. Getting sent back to Narnia. I don't think he can really do anything right now. There's 22 seconds left. Maybe he can get this side flag if the Mace puts up the wall, but I think he already wasted it. Rayleigh's coming in. They'll probably be able to grab the flag. Anti-heal, but the Big Mom is invincible. Nice perfect dodge by the Rayleigh, but he does get killed by the King anyway. So that should be GG. Sadly, their team just couldn't hold it down. Still a really good showcase, though, from Lawffy. Like I said, he does really well against those runners that can't get taken off the flag easy. Just picking them up, messing up these Kings, which is actually pretty nice. But like I said, sadly, they did lose. He actually gave the GG to the Mace, which is pretty interesting. I wouldn't have given it to him, if I'm being honest. We'll check out the score. Ooh, 61 Kaya W. He got top frag with 2 caps, 1 kill with a 4.7k score. Not too shabby. And with that, we will go on to the next match with Lawffy. All right, so I think this is might be the second to last game, or maybe it's the third to last game. I'll have to check. right now, we got Onigashima getting a little bit of variety on matches or maps, and even fucking fighters. Look, I just saw a red Jinbei. Like, holy shit! I have not seen those in a while. That's for damn sure. But we're gonna see what Rage can do on this map. It's a lot more closed in. First team, though, we got Parasparrow, Big Mom, and Zoro named Shinobu. Okay. And then we have an Oni Luffy again, two Kings, and a Boa. So we'll see. Luffy can fuck up Boa a lot, especially because he can't get petrified. I think he might have a little erectile dysfunction. He can't get hard and stiff in the pants or whatever. So, you know, it'll go in his favor. So we'll have to see, but like I said, this map's a little bit more restricted, except for in the middle. So maybe he'll stay a lot more in the middle. He actually grabs the first flag, which I don't know about that, man. That Big Mom's going to probably be punching the air as well. Sees a King popping up, picks him up, punches him right in the dick again. 15k, no crit this time. And just 1-2s and kills the Kings and sends him back to spawn nice and easy. Right here, there's another King. Parasparrow's kind of getting abused right now, but Parasparrow can eat him, and then Rage tried to hit him with the anti-heal. Missed it, though. So right now, he's just going to jump the King with the Parasparrow, letting the Parasparrow actually kill him, so that's fine. Send a good job to the Parasparrow for actually holding that down. Right now, once again, using the normals to move a little bit quicker, the 1-2, getting to the B-flag, trying to cap that. Making sure you're watching the map while you do that. I think somebody might be pulling up right now. Parasparrow comes up, helps them to get the flag. Somebody's coming in right now. Uses the pickup, their little radish picker, whatever you want to call it. Picks up the Boa. Boa dodges, anti-heal, and she is dead. Like I said, Luffy's in general always do good against Boa, so, you know, nothing too crazy there. Green Shanks pulls up. he is hitting him with his normals and healing him, so I don't know about that. He does have team boost right now, though. Shanks uses his teleport skill, hits both Perospero and him. Only Luffy's here as well. I believe the Shanks just dodged it, but he actually got the anti-heal off.
Killing the Shanks as well, so that's pretty good. Once again, picks up the King again. I don't know. I'm telling you, this guy raged at something against Kings. This man's racist for real. Of course, because of the Shandians, but he gets hit with the Tremor. Kind of gets fucked over by the little knockback, goes through it for some reason, and the other King gets it, gets the kill on Rage. But I'm telling you, man, this guy Rage has something against King. I don't even know, man. This guy's just been on their asses the entire matches that I've seen. Every single time that there's a King, he is just on it, which is good, though. He's doing his job. Once again, though, responding with Lawffy. 3.8 score right now with about a minute left. Whiffs at skill 1, or skill 2, just because the Big Mom kind of fucked it over. Could have saved it for this King, but right now he's just kind of waiting for him to get off the flag. Timing it perfectly, getting that anti-heal and another kill. 16k. Wow, that was actually a lot. I think that was a no crit too, so that is something. Stampede Top was pulling up for some reason. I think he might try to get the flag or hold that other side flag down. But right now Rage drops down. He's trying to help the Big Mom, but she is the GOAT because she got it all covered. Once again, picks up the boa. But he just got cummed on by the Jinbei. I mean, it's always a good time, though. Anytime getting squirted on by Jinbei, I wouldn't be against that. Sadly, though, he didn't get to kill the boa. Anti-heals the Jinbei. I think the Jinbei dies to the Big Mom. 5k score with just about a minute left. Tries to steal another kill. This man Rage is just thieving out here. But they should hold it down with 4 flags to 1. The 6.4k score, not too shabby with Lawffy once again. Not the greatest of matches, especially fighting that Green Shanks, but he did hold it down with him. And looking at the stats, we got 3 caps and 4 kills. Not too shabby, like I said. And we will get on to the next match once it loads up. All right, this should be the second to last match, I think. And once again, we are on Onigashima. And the wind is going crazy right now, if you can see it or hear it. Once again, another Perospero on his team. I just noticed that right now. I guess it might be the same player, too. So, like I said, I know he was recording these like back-to-back, so that might be the case. But we will see what the other team has, and we'll go on from there once it loads up. So right now, we got, obviously, Lawffy for him, checking his charge, 9%. Charge your phone, bitch. King, Roger, and Odin. Interesting. And then we have a Big Mom, Odin, I forgot his name, Sentomaru, Fat Boy, and Green Shanks. Odin saying leave it to him, so maybe he got it covered, I'm not too sure. We will have to see right now. A little slight plug, if you haven't seen the Rodin gameplay, it's in the channel, so you can watch it if you want. Rage is also shooting down the little emotes to fight, making sure they're holding it down. Trying to get a little lag there, but he does pick up the Odin off the skill. Hits him for almost half health. Really good. Like I said, gets clipped by the Shanks, though. Trying to get the first flag because his team just did not get it. Dodge glitches. Tries to hit the Shanks with the anti-heal, but he gets hit when he's down for some reason, and he goes down. I hate it when that shit happens. It's usually against Shanks, too, so we'll just wait for Lawffy to come back. Team's not looking too good. King gets the flag, though, from the Shanks. I think he's about to die right now, too, anyway. So King just hitting his normals, trying to get away from the Shanks, but dodges. Perfect dodges that. Or not perfect dodge. Dodge glitches it. Anti-heals the Shanks, but it doesn't matter because he has ignore status. Punches the Odin in his asshole. Gets him to a little past half health. Really good damage, like I said. This Shanks is just on Rage's ass right now and kills him once again. Sadly, so we're just gonna have to wait for Lawffy to come back. Like I said, this is kind of like a really good showing, even though it's not looking the best, just a realistic showing of the unit, because he can be really good, but you know, against like Shanks and those type of characters, he will not do good. So I guess it's a good thing that Rage did add this. Yeah, actually, Lawffy's trying to get the flag. He does pick him up with the room, one shots him with the skill 2. Once again, the Shanks is just on his ass. 1 health, tries to anti-heal, but doesn't matter, and he is dead once again. That Shanks is just getting free stacks at this point. Poor Rage is just getting abused. I know when he was recording it, he was telling me on DMs that it was awful to record it. Sometimes he would just, you know, just get absolutely destroyed. That's why he has Soba Mask on the side now instead of Shanks like he had prior. Pulling back, though, we have the Frankie punching the living shit out of the Roger. Rage throwing the anti-heal on the Roger, because I know that Frankie actually wouldn't have killed him since he was healing him a lot. Helping the King cap the flag. And trying to push for the next flag. The big one's pulling up. You can kind of see her big-ass sword. Picks her up like a radish. Team boost almost one-shots her. 15k. Not too bad, especially in her flag. She does a dodge and just gets hit with a 10k crit normal. That is insane. Dodges off the flag because he sees something coming up. It was EX Lawffy, but he pulled out his invincibility, so the anti-heal did not proc. Sad to see that. The other Odin's pulling up. Rage should be dead here, I think. Getting hit with the stun. Yep, and he goes down to the EX Lawffy. Sad to see once again. I think he might be pulling up with Silver Mask now. Trying to clutch up. His team's not looking too good. There's not that many runners. Pair of Sparrow's the only one that's still alive. He pops out the skill too to kick him back. And look at that EX Lawffy. He just got candy mid-hit. Making sure you don't get hit by that EX Lawffy right there. He's on the middle flag. They're not watching the map, so they don't see him coming up. And they just keep on getting candied by the Pair of Sparrow, so it's pretty good. But they won't be able to hold it down or to get another flag, sadly. So that is GG. Frankie's mad. Everybody's sending good games. Pair of saying to gather up, but I think they were too bunched up anyway, sadly. That match wasn't the greatest. Two kills, one cap, you know, just showing off just how, you know, power creep works in this game. And that was the last game for Lawffy. Once again, let me know what you guys thought about the gameplay if you want in the comments. I won't be doing too many commentary stuff, so this can kind of like a rare bunch. Honestly, he did do really good though, for what he was supposed to do. Like I said, there's a lot of just waiting around being basically a pussy and just like waiting for his skills to pop out. You know, you're not gonna be straight up fighting people 24/7. I think Rage had a good showing on how, you know, good he can be in that last match, especially getting wrecked by that Shanks basically 24/7 is also pretty realistic for Lawffy as well. Once again, just let me know what you guys think about this guy. With that being said, this team 3-star sign out. Probably not doing commentary for a while, but hopefully you enjoyed it, and till next time, peace.